قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: من شهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله، وأن عيسى عبد الله ورسوله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه، والجنة حق والنار حق، أدخله الله الجنة على ما كان من العمل، أخرجاه. This hadith narrated by Ubad ibn Samit, it says, whoever testifies that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah without any partner, and testifies that Muhammad is the slave and the messenger of Allah, and testifies that Isa, the slave of Allah and his messenger, and the word that was bestowed upon Maryam, and spirit from Allah, and the Jannah is truth, and the Nar is truth, Allah will make him enter paradise according to his action. This hadith has many benefits. The first benefit of this hadith is whoever testifies that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. Testimony always has to be preceded with knowledge. You can never testify to that what you do not know. So testimony comes after knowledge is inculcated in the heart. After a person knows in his heart that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. Nothing worthy to direct your adherence, obedience, and surrendering out of love and glorification except Allah. This is the definition of worship. And what is worship? To adhere, to obey, and to surrender out of love and glorification. Who is worthy to submit that to? Only Allah. Nobody is worthy to be adhered to, surrendered to, obeyed out of love and glorification and fear except Allah. Jesus is not worthy of that. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not worthy of that. Definitely the statues are not worthy of that. The leaders are not worthy of that. The scholars of Al-Islam are not worthy of that. The angels are not worthy of that. Jibreel is not worthy of that. Only Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is worthy of that. If we know that, if this knowledge is inculcated in our heart, then we have to announce and pronounce and declare this knowledge to the people. That means whoever testifies. And there is a secret to that. What does testimony mean? Can you testify to something that you do not see? Can you testify? Is your testimony will be accepted for something that you have not seen? So have you seen that Allah is one? So how can you testify? Because the knowledge is so much ascertained in your heart. The knowledge is so much ascertained and strong in your heart, it came to the level of knowing that Allah is one. This is why Allah said, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. You don't see Allah, but you see His creation. And His creation testifies that He is one. Look in yourself. Within yourself, the most evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is magnificent. In your own creation are ample evidence that Allah is magnificent and Allah is one. If there were two creators, everyone will create things to oppose the other. But there is only one creator. There is only one creator. That means we cannot accept Jesus is the Son of God and He is divine. That means Jesus is a creator. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship, and we testify to that out of our knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. Those who testify without knowledge, those who testify only by their lips, their testimony is not accepted, because this is the testimony of the hypocrite, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about in Surah Al-Munafiqun. In Surah Al-Munafiqun, what did they say? نَشْهَدُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ. The hypocrite says, we testify that you are the messenger of Allah. But this testimony was not supported by knowledge and faith. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُهُ وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَكَاذِبُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that you are His messenger. He does not need their testimony to affirm that fact. Allah knows that, and Allah is testifying that the hypocrites are lying. That means they are saying in their tongue what is not in their heart. That is hypocrisy. To say in the tongue what is not in the heart. And let me tell you a part of that. There's two types of hypocrisy. Social hypocrisy, which is very much spread in our society. A person will see a person, Assalamu alaikum, how are you, brother? And he laughs in himself and he laughs in his face. And after he leaves, he talks back to his brother. This is social hypocrisy because we say in his tongue what is not in their heart. I'm only saying that because this subject came and it was a good opportunity to say that. But hypocrisy in this ayah refers that those people are saying in their tongues that they are testifying the Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, but in their heart they're not accepting that. That means the believers, they know that in their heart, and this knowledge is ascertained, very much certain in their heart and inculcated within their heart, and they are pronouncing that to the people. So they are testifying, there's no deity worthy of worship except Allah. And they are testifying that Muhammad is the messenger, the slave, and the messenger of Allah Azza wa Jal. What we are testifying Muhammad to be? The partner of Allah? Are we testifying Muhammad is Allah's partner? We are testifying Muhammad is the slave of Allah Azza wa Jal. Therefore, we have to put the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his exact position, not higher and not lower. A lot of people, they put Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam lower in his position. They do not accept him as the messenger and the prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some people put the Prophet as equivalent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a partner to Allah azza wa jal. Some of the Sufi creed, they say, Allah created first Muhammad. And from the light of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everything was created. And that's very much incoherent with the creed of the Jehovah Witnesses, who come and they say, we do not believe Isa to be the Son of God. Alhamdulillah, this is good. What do you believe? We say we believe God created Isa first, and from Isa, everything was created. That is very much in accordance to some of the sects of Sufi that they say Muhammad was created first, and from the light of Muhammad, everything was created. And some people make poetry in praise of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of them said, يَا أَكْرَمَ الْخَلْقِ مَا لِي مَنْ أَلُوذُ بِهِ سِوَاكَ عند حلول الحادث العملي إن لم تكن يوم المعاد آخذا بيدي فضلا وإلا فقل يا ذلة القدم فإن من جودك الدنيا وضرتها ومن علومك علم اللوح والقلم. قال ابن رجب وغيره إنه لم يترك لله شيئا. This person is praising Prophet Muhammad and he said to him, the most honorable from the creation, which is correct. He said, who's going to protect me except you?